On the Medical Watch, it's a debilitating disease that affects 1 in 500 African Americans.
And medical reporter Dina Baer has an update on a treatment for sickle cell anemia.
They're siblings who spent their childhood in and out of the hospital as they struggled with the inherited blood disorder. Then, as young adults, an opportunity to undergo a cutting-edge treatment. At the time, doctors called it a cure. Was it?
Devastating to look, you know, to watch your kids and you can do nothing.
We first introduced you to the Means family in 2013. Then 25-year-old Julius, along with his younger brother Desmond, were babies when they were diagnosed with sickle cell anemia, an inherited defect of the red blood cells.
Some of my first memories having sickle cell, you know, just, you know, being planned and then, you know, one day, then the next day, not being able to even walk.
More rigid than normal round cells, the crescent or sickle-shaped cells get stuck in small vessels and block the delivery of oxygen to organs, tissues, and joints. The result, chronic and intense pain.
The majority of the pain usually would hit me in my legs and my back. So to be a young kid and not be able to play with the other kids a lot of the time was pretty awful.
The kidney, the liver, the heart, the lung get worse and worse. In fact, many of these patients die within before they age, like before the age 40 or 50.
The best hope, a stem cell transplant. Doctors infuse healthy donor cells that gradually take over the patient's bone marrow to produce normal red blood cells. But at the time, the procedure required high doses of chemotherapy to kill off a patient's own cells and prep the body to accept the new ones, a practice deemed too dangerous for some sickle cell patients.
It depends on how old they are and how long the disease has been working in their body.
Then a breakthrough. University of Illinois at Chicago, Dr. Damiana Rondelli, offered Julius and Desmond an experimental alternative using more tolerable immunosuppressing drugs. Older brother Clifford served as their stem cell donor.
Most of them basically have gone back to a normal life.
It's been awesome. I've been able to like really, to really work, go out and have fun without always having to worry about, you know, getting sick.
No hospitalization since the treatment. Today, Julius and Desmond are free from their debilitating pain.
I can't think of any other condition that we transplant that has such a big impact in so many patients.
And we've been real good, real blessed.
Doctors at UIC have performed about 50 stem cell transplants without chemotherapy with a 75% success rate. And they're now working on a gene editing procedure for sickle cell patients, another major breakthrough to help end the pain. Back to you.